हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू शिक्षा मंत्र वंस अगेन। एंड इन शिक्षा मंत्र वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, एज वी हैव सेड अर्लियर इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो, दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सम वेरी टिपिकल वर्ब टर्म्स हियर इन आवर प्रेजेंटेशन। सो फॉलोइंग दैट लाइन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी new types of verbs. Probably someone of you knows and most of you have heard it for the first time, and that verb is called ambitransitive verbs. Yes dear friends, our topic today is ambitransitive verbs. Now what is ambitransitive verbs? The very name is suggestive of what it means, ambitransitives. So we are going to get the details of this verb and we are going to learn this verb in detail. So stay tuned till the end. And before we start it, so here I would like to tell you another thing, that if you want to get the details of these verbs in a PDF form or in docs form, obviously you'd have to visit my Telegram channel Shiksha Mantra. The link is given in the description below. So visit that channel and subscribe there for many such beautiful things. So let's start our discussion regarding ambitransitive verbs. What is it? Okay, before we shift to ambitransitive, it's better to discuss the word ambitransitive first. So here it comes, ambi. Now what is ambi? Ambi is a prefix that occurring in loan words from Latin, meaning both, as it's in ambiguous, and round as it's in ambient. So used in the formation of compound verbs. So have an example how ambi works. And here it says ambidextrous. If you follow this word, you'd get the same prefix ambi here as well. Now what does the word ambidextrous mean? It means able to use the left hand or the right hand equally well. So both the hand, here ambi is used in the sense of both. Now one can use both his left hand and right hand equally well, so he is ambidextrous. Now what does it mean for ambitransitive? Does it have any relation with ambitransitive? So let's learn the definition first. Some action verbs can be both transitive and intransitive depending on the context of the sentence or what information the speaker wishes to intune. So some action verbs, I'm repeating it, can be both transitive and intransitive, both transitive and intransitive. So these are known as ambitransitive verbs. So this is transitive in one hand and intransitive on the other, transitive as well as intransitive, and that's the key to this verb. So let's see some examples, and with these examples we'll learn the details. The first one is I drove home. So drove, this is the verb, and here home is obviously not the object, that's why this is intransitive. Here the word drive is used intransitively. And then comes I drove my car home. Now my car, when you put this drove, this verb gets an object, yes, and now the verb is used transitively. So drive, here it's written in past tense, that's why drove, but if you consider in present, the verb drive, it is both transitive and intransitive. Actually, a verb doesn't get either transitive or intransitive. Actually, what we do, we use the verb either transitively or intransitively. So drive, this verb can be used both transitively and intransitively, and we call this ambitransitive verb. And there's another, see played, and see played a game. So here you can see very clearly that see played, there's no object after this. See played a game, there's an object. So play, it's used once intransitively and then transitive. So it can be used as both transitive and intransitive, and we call this ambitransitive verb. That's it, and that's how it works. But we don't stop here. We have many other in store for you to discuss. English has many ambitransitive verbs, and we are going to get details of them. How? The first one. Examples include read, break, and understand. That is, I read the book. Here, saying what was read, or just I read all afternoon, saying the time. So for the first sentence, it's transitive read, and for the second, it's intransitive. We do this with another so that you can remember the verb read as ambitransitive verb. You must remember one example, at least one example, to get to the details of this. I read my newspaper. So my newspaper. You get what? You get obviously an object, and it becomes transitive. Then comes another sentence. I read in bed. So in bed, that's only, yes, adverbial. And here you don't get any object. That's why your read is transitive. So that's how ambitransitive gets this word read. It's transitively used as well as used intransitively. So this is ambitransitive. And now let's learn it in detail. More detail is needed. This is by far the most common type of verb in English. Ambitransitive verbs can either have no object or can have an object. We have learned it. In similarity to transitive verbs, ambitransitive verbs can be used in passive voice as long as they have an object in active voice. They cannot have an object in passive voice. And there we would get an example again. So how is it? Type and examples. That's how our discussion would go on. Intransitive. Here, Mary sings. So sing. This is a word that is used intransitively. Then transitive in active voice. Mary sings a song. Mary sings a song. So sings. This verb is used here as transitively. So here, sing gets in an ambitransitive verb, used both transitively and intransitively, but that's in active voice. So what happens when it comes to passive voice? The song was sung by Mary. So by Mary, it gets what? An object. And it becomes passive form of this ambitransitive verb, sing. So that's how it goes. Transitive, active voice, transitive, passive voice, and also in intransitive form. So here we are going to have another question. Do they have any group? So let's see whether ambitransitive is alone or it have some brothers and sisters. Yes, ambitransitive verbs need to be divided into three groups. What are these three groups? Those that can have gerund clauses or infinitive clauses as their complements. Those that can only have gerund clauses as their complements. And those that can only have infinitive clauses as their complements. So I have some examples here also. The first one, I have been trying to read more. I have been trying to read more. Used intransitively. Follow read. Then, I have been trying to read more novels. Now follow this one, more novels, and it becomes transitive. Why? Here it gets an object. And then we have another example. I'm still cooking, so I'm going to be a little late. Intransitive, I'm still cooking. There's no object. So I'm still cooking dinner, so I'm going to be a little late. It's transitive here. Then comes our next example, and it says, I have been exercising every day this month. Exercising every day this month. Intransitive. Then I have been exercising my arms every day this month. My arms, it gets an object. So it becomes transitive. So that's how, when a verb is used both transitively and intransitively, we call this ambitransitive. And if you want a list of these verbs, that is these ambitransitive verbs, you have to visit my Telegram channel, and there you'd find a list of them as well. So visit it, subscribe it. You'd find the link in the description below. And it's time for us to tell you bye-bye. And it's time for you, if you have reached this Star channel for the very first time, to subscribe with the bell icon pressed so that you get all the notifications about this. We are returning with another fresh Vogue charms like this. So stay tuned to our channel and happy learning.